friends, how are ya? Welcome back to my channel for a very casual video that I honestly kind of never really thought I would make, and a decision that I never really thought I would make, but alas, we are here, and as I'm sure you could tell by the title, I have decided to quit acting. And wow, that's the first time I said that out loud. Sounds really, really odd to say. This is clearly a huge part of me and has been a huge part of me for virtually my whole life, and I've kind of almost made it my identity. But I am just going to explain how I got to this decision, why I'm making this decision, and what I plan to do. And I haven't really planned out exactly what I'm gonna say and how I'm going to explain this to you. And in fact, I haven't even tried to say a lot of these thoughts or feelings out loud until literally right now. So I'm gonna do my best to put my feelings and emotions into words. And actually, as of the filming of this video, my manager knows, and I've had a conversation with him about what my plans are and what I'm feeling, but my agents don't know yet at the filming of this video. I have my emails drafted to them and ready to send, but I obviously am gonna hold off on posting this video until after I let them know. No, because I love my agents so much. I've genuinely become such good friends with them, especially my agent Julie. I love her with my whole heart. So it's gonna be really hard to let them know. So I'm kind of just procrastinating it until the last minute, but where to begin? So I have been a represented actor, meaning I have been signed with agencies for over 15 years now, and I'm only 23. So literally the majority of my life, I have had agents and managers that send me to auditions, and I go out for those auditions, and I have done that in all areas of acting, from commercial to print to theatrical, which is TV and film, to voiceover, to hosting, to everything. And it has truly become my identity. I mean, it is why I moved here. I went to a performing arts high school. It's something that I'm really proud of, and I'm really proud of sticking with it this long because, I didn't expect to get emotional. You know how when you're a little kid and everybody asks you what you want to be when you grow up, and people have all these crazy dreams of like, I want to be an astronaut, I want to be whatever. I felt really proud of myself for being the only little kid to say, I want to be an actor, and then sticking to that into adulthood. I'm the only one I know out of all of my friends that has had a clear-cut dream since being a child and has stuck with that clear-cut dream for years and years and years into adulthood and has planned my life around it. And acting is still something that I love so much, but it's beginning to get a little bit messy and my heart is beginning to resent it a little bit, and I don't think it's a healthy relationship any longer. And to me, it feels like I'm going through a breakup with someone I've been in a relationship with for 15 years but had a crush on even longer than that. And I've never dumped someone before in like relationships. I've always been broken up with, and I feel like this is the first time I'm having to break up with someone even though I truly love them. And it's a very weird situation because this someone isn't even a person. It's a career, it's an idea, it's a path. But I have found something that I really love, and that is creating content and being an entrepreneur, which is such a weird, vague term, but I really truly thrive working for myself, and I love having creative control in the content creating world and in everything I'm doing. In the acting world, it's a lot of fun, but you have no control, and you have to wait on so many people, and you have to wait for permission to do so many things. You can even book a role and never make it to set because so many things can fall through, from contracts to budgeting reasons to so many different things, that you're always just waiting on other people to make the opportunities happen for you. And you can hustle and you can audition, but at the end of the day, like, you're relying on other people to either say, all right, let's go forward with this, or like, sorry, that just didn't work out. And you don't have control over the script or the content or anything like that. And so I've really enjoyed this career where I can have an idea and literally put it into motion the exact same day, and I don't have to ask anybody for permission. And so because of that, I've really become fulfilled in this world that I'm doing now. And whenever I get auditions, I have just noticed that I'm no longer excited for auditions, which is so odd. Like, I look at auditions as taking time away from what I really want to be doing. I even will book jobs. Like, I will book work and I'll be like, I don't want to go to set that day. I had this video planned and like the pay isn't that great. I'm gonna be honest here, a lot of it does boil down to money too. Like, being an actor, you get paid crap. I mean, you can make good money sometimes, but at the end of the day, you're only guaranteed $500 or $700 day rate for a shoot. And when all is said and done, you're paying taxes, you're paying your manager, you're paying your agents. When all is said and done, I'm making less than I would make at a shift at the restaurant I worked at. So money is a big part of it too, though it shouldn't be, and I hate to admit that, but it literally is costing me money to go to auditions and to book work that should be making me money. And so because of it taking time away from what I really want to do and literally costing me money, I kind of built up this resentment in my heart. And there's also this weird thing in the acting world that you can book out, meaning you can tell your agents and your managers like, hey, I'm gonna be out of town for these 5 days, I'm gonna book out. And it's kind of like requesting time off of work. It's kind of the same mentality where you should let them know like 2, 3, 4 weeks in advance, and you shouldn't really book out more than like 2 weeks a year. It's kind of just like an unspoken rule that it's impolite to do so. But even when you book out, you'll still get self-tapes when you're gone on vacation, and you'll still get auditions beforehand. Like, if I'm booked out December 1st through 10th, in November, I'm gonna get auditions for roles that shoot December 1st through 10th. So even if I really wanted to go on that family vacation in December, this has happened to me countless times. I will book a job, and then I'll have to decide, well, do I wanna take this job and cancel my trip or miss part of my trip? Or do I wanna risk making my reps upset and declining this job, declining this money, declining this work that we've all worked so hard to get so that I can go on this trip, even though I've already let everyone know ahead of time about this trip? And so that situation has always made me really anxious every time I have a trip, every time I want to go home and see my family, or like my mom is coming into town tonight, actually, that I'm filming this, and I've had auditions pop up when she's here, and I had a callback last week for a commercial that was going to shoot the whole time she was here. And so I was just thinking like, God, I don't want to book this because I really value quality time with my mom more than this job. So a lot of me too was really tired of never being able to fully enjoy time off or time with my family, and always feeling anxious and always feeling like I have to choose work over being with them. And then there's also this silly thing too of like, I wanted to cut my hair for months and months and months, and I kept booking jobs, so I kept not being able to cut my hair. And I don't know what it's like to be able to cut my hair without asking permission. Like, my whole life I've tried to keep my look consistent because that's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to look like your headshots. And I had an audition last week that I don't know if I'm gonna book, and maybe I'll be on set next week, and if I cut my hair this week before I even book it, like, I could get in trouble. And like, all of these little things, I just feel like I've never been able to fully live my life for my own. Like, I've always been anxiously curating my life around the what ifs in acting. Everything is about the what ifs, and the what ifs can be exciting. Like, it is so exciting when you don't think you're gonna book a role that you really want, and then you do book it. But like, the fact of the matter is, you go to so many auditions and you book so few, and the pay isn't that good, and you're just anxiously planning your whole life around it. I don't know if you watched the vlog that I posted a while ago. I don't know when this video is coming out, but where I had a callback and like this self-tape, I sent in a self-tape same day. They wanted an audition same day. And then at 8 p.m. at night, they were like, by tonight, can you actually redo it? Because we decided we want to see something else. And I was like, well, what if I was, you know, working my restaurant job? Like, you just expect me to be able to do this tonight? And then I ended up getting a call back for it the next day, found out the next day. And it was supposed to be at like 4 p.m. And at 2 p.m. they're like, oh, we're actually gonna move it to 3 p.m. And I was like, cool, so I gotta leave now. Like, thank goodness I'm able to do that, because otherwise I'd be screwed. And there's just kind of this like lack, and it's not from my agents or my managers or anything like that. It's just the industry. There's like this almost lack of respect for other people's time in the acting world, where it's like, oh, we know you want this job. Like, we know you want it. This is so competitive that you'll do anything to get this role. And so we don't even care what you have going on today. We need you to be here now at the drop of the hat. By the way, this pays $300, you know? I feel like I sound, I don't know, out of touch saying that, but I'm just trying to honestly put into thoughts and feelings how I feel. And all of these things together have built up inside of me for years now, ever since I started finding my own passions and things that I truly enjoy. And I think that it's just now gotten to a point to where I am gonna grow more without this relationship than with this relationship. And I was texting, I have a group text with my best friends from childhood, and I let them know like my thought process and what I'm feeling. And I was like, I really feel like I'm breaking up with a boyfriend that I've had for 15 years. And my friend Hallie said this, it's kind of cheesy, but for some reason, even though it's cheesy, it's exactly what I needed to hear. She said, okay, this is so dumb, but Taylor Swift's song 15 started playing in my head while reading that. The part that goes, quote, back then I swore I was gonna marry him someday, but I realized some bigger dreams of mine. She said, and IDK, but that feels deep. I feel like you're doing more than you could have ever imagined when you started acting or when you moved to LA. I think it's a good breakup. And it is crazy that just in 3 years of me taking control of my own career, I have done so much more and been able to be self-employed, whereas in 15 years of acting and waiting on directors and producers and casting directors and all of these things, like, I haven't in reality gotten very far. Like, I haven't. And I am a firm believer that being successful in the acting industry is just sticking it out. And that's what made me stick it out. But I've kind of gotten to the point where I'm like, is it worth sticking it out even if I do become successful? Is that even really what I want anymore? And I think the answer is no. So what's next? Well, I actually am keeping my manager and I am keeping my hosting agent, because to me, hosting is not acting. I'm no longer gonna go out for commercial auditions, voiceover auditions, TV roles, film roles, anything like that. Not to say that maybe one day an opportunity might come knocking at my door. I would definitely say yes to it. I mean, like, so many people in the social media world, like, freaking Addison Rae, doesn't she have her own show now? I don't think she's ever acted before in her life. Like, that's becoming a thing. So at least if that opportunity came knocking at my door, I could be like, yeah, I was an actor for 15 years. Like, I know what to expect and I know that world and I have those skill sets. So this is not me saying goodbye to it forever, but this is me no longer actively pursuing it. But to me, hosting, if you don't know, like when I was on Taste Made, that's hosting. HGTV people, those are hosts. Hosting, I am Michel Janse. I am still me. I am not Michel Janse as role, or I'm not Samsung girl or Target girl or whatever in a commercial. I'm me. I'm myself. It's unscripted. To me, it feels like building blocks in the same tower as what I'm trying to accomplish right now. And we actually have some really, really exciting things in the works with my hosting agent. I signed with a really big deal agency that I was really excited to sign with, and he already has so many exciting things in the works that I've had incredible meetings. I wish I could tell you all about them. Maybe one day if they work out. I mean, you'll definitely know if they work out. So from here on out, I'm going to have the majority of my time to focus on what I want to focus on. Creating content for you guys, building my brand, working on Janse the label, working on being Michel Janse in more places rather than chasing this dream of being an actor. And I also have meetings considering transitioning my management to helping to manage my YouTube channel, because it's gotten to the point with sponsorships, like, it's amazing, but it's a little bit overwhelming to where I get 50 to 100 emails a day, given probably 70% of them are crap, but I still get probably 10 really good sponsorship opportunities every single day. And like, to sort through them and to be picky about them and to negotiate them is like a lot of work. I spend hours and hours a day doing that. So I know I need management help in that sense. And I know I need someone who has a background in law and understands contracts and negotiations. And it's just going to be interesting to see if it works out with my current managers to transition into this world, because though this world is similar to the acting world in terms of contracts and negotiations, it's also so different in terms of terminology. And that is just something that is not in the acting world at all. So that's the next thing I have to figure out, is if I want to have official representation in this world or not. And if my current manager, who I love and I never want to stop working with no matter what I do, is the right fit to then manage this channel with me or not. Or if I need to seek out an additional new representation to work alongside with my management. Nobody has two managers, which is a weird thing to transition from the acting world to this world, is like, people either have an acting manager or they have a influencer manager. I hate that term. So that's something sticky and weird, but like the acting world was starting to get muddy. And I'm sure you even saw in the vlog a while ago as well, where I was talking about how the acting world was starting to request exclusivity over the influencer world. So I had a commercial that paid like $1,000 and wanted me to never work with a subscription box ever again, to have exclusivity over subscription boxes. And I was like, well, that cuts out like 70% of my salary, because the majority of my income is working with subscription boxes, so I could never agree to that deal. So this was just a very long-winded, rambly way to explain where my heart is at, where my head is at, where my plans are at. I need to send this email to my agents, and I'm terrified of doing it because I feel like that is the official breakup text in this relationship of sorts. But if this video's out, it means I did it. And there's a slim, slim, slim chance that I will tell my commercial agency, because I love them dearly, that if they ever find a commercial that's like a union commercial, pays, you know, back in the good old days, if you booked a union commercial, you could make maybe 6 figures off of it. Those are the things that you see like during the Super Bowl, things like that. I'm gonna tell them like if they wanna keep me on the roster for those opportunities, which would literally be like once or twice a year, then by all means feel free to, but that's up to them and that's a decision for them to make if they would like to, you know, have me in their back pocket for those rare opportunities. But also, I am the majority. I am a 18 to 25 year old Caucasian brunette female. Like, I am the most replaceable category in the acting world. That's just the fact of the matter. The majority of the people in LA that are trying to audition look like me, and I don't have anything unique about me. To be honest, I don't have a special skill. I don't have a special look. I can't be ethnically ambiguous in any way, shape, or form. I am just like the white girl, and there's far too many of us in LA, and so it's really not beneficial, I think, for agencies to hold on to me either, because I am so replaceable, and that's just the fact of the matter in this industry, which is very blatant to say, but it is the truth. This was probably one of the most honest videos I've ever filmed, because a lot of this was my first time saying it out loud. Like I said, I haven't really tried to put these thoughts and feelings into words. I've just been thinking and feeling them generally for the last year or two, and I think it's time. So that's what's next. A lot of you asked me if I was moving. I'm not moving. I am staying in LA for the foreseeable future. The honest truth is Brooke has his dream job, and his dream job can only happen here. And I think my relationship with LA will improve, no longer acting, because since I had built up these resentful feelings towards acting, I kind of paired it with LA, because I only lived in LA in my mind for acting. So since acting felt no longer worth my time, LA felt no longer worth my time. So I think letting go of acting, I will feel like I'm choosing to live here, and it will allow me to fall back in love with LA. And as long as Brooke has his job, we will be here. And that's the fact of the matter. Unless one day we can afford a home both in Texas and in LA, which would be really nice, but probably impossible. But no, we're not moving. We're here. So those are all the updates. I love y'all. Thank you for listening and caring. And I'm terrified, but I know this is the right decision. Just like I was terrified to quit my night job, but I knew it was the right decision. Just like I was terrified to move to LA when I was 18, but I knew it was the right decision. This is the exact same feeling. I'm terrified, but I know it's the right decision. And I'm the type of person that has to act on those things immediately. So I'm gonna act on it now. I love you so much. I hope you have the best rest of your day, and I will see you in a video very soon. Thanks for listening to me ramble. Bye.
I hear the sound of empty streets. Yesterday has gone to sleep. So all that's left is you and me. I can't promise you're the only thing I see.